Giles. Giles.
Bersh, I sent you the link.
Very warm day outside by Minnesota standards, but then again, it is still summer. Either way, the AC is working just fine at US Bank Stadium in the Twins.
I'm streaming.
Today, it's week three, and we've got a good one in store, as it'll be the LA Chargers taking on the Minnesota Vikings.
Yeah, I sent it in on Snap, bro. Chill.
Okay. Nyheim Hines now out of his end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17.
Oh, I had a touchdown.
Back in his own seven. Miles Garrett. He's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of nine. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And he's gonna go down in the end zone. Cousins taken down for the safety. Well, what do we think these two defenses?
Getting no blocking.
Because if it turns out to be a tight game, who knows? This could wind up being the difference.
And pretty good field position here. He's out of bounds right at the 35.
Is that right?
Ball up to the 35 now.
Because you're 0-3.
Here's Stroud. This will go to Henry out wide. Finding room at midfield. Down the left sideline. Inside the 10.
Yeah, for sure.
And the Chargers are able to strike quickly to add on to the lead. Now for the end.
Yeah, my defense isn't good. I'm not good. Game might be over right now.
And this is good as they extend it out now to a 9-0 lead.
I'll get six. You might have to let me get six.
Out of the end zone, here comes Hines. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20.
Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. They trail now 9-0. The opening safety followed by the touchdown a moment ago. So an early hole to dig out of as the drive starts, first and 10. Ball on the 27. Here's second down and 1. Cousins throw caught by his receiver Hill. The first catch for the man leading the NFL in receiving yards in this first month. And a first down to boot. The Vikings at 2-0 here to begin the season. And they come in feeling pretty good after back-to-back victories, CD.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
I didn't want to throw it. That's why I threw a touch pass. I'm a bot. Yeah, dude, I'm not good.
Defensive backs, did he need to be more careful throwing the football? I mean, I guess obviously hindsight he did, but
yeah, hindsight, but even in foresight, when you
well, you did pick Geno Smith. that sounds like a you problem.
You don't have much reaction time for your receivers to go get the football because those guys, they're the best cover guys on the field. They go get it, and on that play, they took it the other way for 6 points.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And no return.
Jeez. You guys aren't even going to be even close to the Fofs. Yeah, I guess.
Vikings now to start their next drive. They find themselves in a good size hole here, and a good size hole early on in this game as they come up on
what?
A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Throwing, Cousins.
Yo, dude, I don't even know what I can do there. Maybe I'll hit my phone. No, I don't like him.
That is the third sack this offensive line has allowed this first quarter.
Yeah, that puts him on pace. Let me do the rudimentary math here. To be sacked 12 times in a game, I know he's not going to go for that. I wonder if it's going to reshape what they decide to do on offense in terms of play calling.
Well, I can tell you what, when he popped up, shaking his head, frustrated right now behind center. So they're going to come to the line here, and it appears trying to go for it on fourth. The open man is Shark. It's complete. And he is going to pick up the Vikings' first down. They needed four. They got eight. And it results in a conversion on fourth down. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete. DJ Chark, the intended target. That'll bring up second down. When you talk about the defense for these Chargers, and this unit, very tough to throw against. Currently second best in the NFL.
Yeah, this has been a good defense, but they're going to have to really prove it in this one because, guess what? They're facing the number one passing offense in the NFL. It's definitely a prove-it day for them.
Third and short yardage, Cousins. Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. Picked up by Sean Murphy Bunting.
Gardner, I think this is where long-term starters in the NFL separate themselves from the rest of the pack because
kind of, yeah.
3 quarters left in this one. Enough time to move past a pair of early mistakes and find a way to lead your team to a win. Mental resiliency, a characteristic every NFL team's looking for in their quarterback.
DeMario Davis there. This defense for the Vikings, very strong last week as they helped their squad improve to 2-0 on the young season.
And no matter what's done throughout a ball game, it always comes down to blocking and tackling. That's the essence of football. But I think it's hard for people to understand just how difficult it is to tackle, especially open field. Very few missed tackles on tape that I saw last game. This team does a nice job of getting their opponents on the ground. The good signal call is we never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well.
That could be the stop this defense needed to get them back on track. They've been pretty well dissected by the offense here. After that possession, now they know that they can
Seems like a you problem.
Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
That was nice work there defensively to force incompletion. Now, even though this drive started in plus territory, they're still not field goal range yet. So they can work towards another couple of stops and not allowing that turnover to hurt.
Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete.
Well, after incompletions on first and second down, it certainly seems like a reflection of what we've seen so far in this game. The defense, quicker to the punch so far. Let's see if they can get something going here on third down.
On third down, Cousins. And that is incomplete. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They've given him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
Tucker's kick is good. Wow, I mean, it's so rare to even
points.
Attempt it from that distance, CD, let alone converted, but he came through with confidence and matches what was Tom Dempsey's 43-year NFL record at one point of 63 yards.
Yeah, I can still see that highlight of Dempsey making that kick, and nowadays we see it a little bit differently because remember Dempsey was a straight out.
That's all right.
These guys nowadays, the range keeps increasing, and they keep putting.
Pretty sure everyone knew that that was coming. Had to.
First down carry for Henry. And he'll power ahead, but only for about 3 yards. Second down coming up. Hey, look at this defense for the Vikings. This unit currently seventh in the NFL, Charles, in stopping the run.
They've established themselves as a top 10 run-stopping unit in the NFL here in the early going. All signs point to me towards them continuing that throughout the season. They look pretty good, pretty darn cohesive to me.
First down marker at the 31. It's third down. Stroud on third down now. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
This defense has certainly played well so far in this game, and the coverage has been tight. And just
I don't know.
Forced a few runs so far in this game, and now it brings up fourth down.
So now they're going to send out the field goal unit to, as they say, fire away from long distance. And he has got it from 55 yards away. That was never in doubt. And that will extend their lead even further. These kickers now, it's like we take them for granted. Kicks like that used to be such a big deal, and now you just expect them to make it.
Yeah, you're exactly right, and we shouldn't take them for granted. But I have a theory about it. You want to hear it?
Yeah.
They are more athletic now than ever before. Talk about kickers. Trace their backgrounds, trace their histories. You'll find that they were big-time athletes all along, but their kicking was so prevalent that we made them specialists. Yeah,
and now those 50-plus yarders seem easy for some reason. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. Last time out, you remember their drive stalled, but thanks to their kicker, booted a long field goal to at least get them three. Now here they'll try to do better and find the end zone.
And in our experience, how much fun is it for coaches to know that they've got a kicker who can nail it from long distance? Now the hard part is, as an offensive play caller, you don't want that in your head too much where you're relying on it, and he goes out and gets the job done for them. But I'm quite sure he would be content to just kick extra points from here on out.
Yeah, absolutely, no question. I think his teammates would be okay with him just kicking the extra points as well. On second down, McCaffrey. And he's going to get across midfield and into Charger territory. The Vikings on third down.
What the fuck?
Good, 0 for 4 thus far. This is third and 9. The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts. Two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Now Cousins. gets to McCaffrey complete. And he'll lose yardage here back at the 47. It'll be a loss of 4 yards on the play. And that's going to bring up a fourth down.
I know, he's easy.
They'll indeed go for it. It's Cousins. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Isaiah Rodgers. And they will finally get him as he's all the way down near the 40-yard line.
Okay, ready?
It's Henry. Past the 20. Down to the 10. And he takes it in for a charge.
It's not me, bro.
Derek Henry. His third rushing touchdown on the year.
I don't know what else I'm supposed to do there, Birsch. I guessed run. I sent everyone. There's nothing I can do.
Turnover sets it up and then a touchdown run here on the ensuing play.
Brandon, a lot of times you see teams take shots in the passing game on a quick change like this and go right back and throw one in the end zone. Here, he's a few yards, but he's able to work his way downfield and take it into the end zone. The end result, the exact same thing as going for it in the passing game.
Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Vikings take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Here are the Vikings now to start the next drive. It's still early in this one, but the last time this offense was out there, they threw their first interception of the ball game, so...
And to put a positive spin on it, at least in the first half and not in a close game in the fourth quarter.
Some would say.
You're absolutely right, partner. One of the last things this offensive quarterback wants to witness again in this game.
Kind of an obvious question, Charles, but anything you try to avoid after your first pick, or you say it's one interception, we're still in the first half, I'm about to do the same thing.
I think you want to avoid playing scared.
I'm going
to
knock up.
That you've lost confidence in him. Make sure you get some throws that he's going to be able to complete. Make him feel good about himself and continue to run your offense.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
Murray seen him catch a few passes out of the backfield in the first half, unable to connect on that one.
Certainly seems like getting him the ball in a passing game, though, is part of their game plan.
It certainly is, because he catches it well, creates a mismatch. You're going to cover him with a linebacker, a corner, a safety. They feel like he can win every battle.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
I was trying to get deep, dude. I got to score some points.
Something happen, push the ball downfield and try and gain some points that way. Unfortunately, incomplete.
Now Cousins on fourth down, and his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Isaiah Rodgers. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six and a Charger TD. So they go on fourth down. Not only do they not get it, it turns into 6 points the other way, disastrous.
And many people think you should just go ahead and knock it down in that situation, turn it over for the offense. But I had a defensive coordinator recently tell me, we see that as a passive play. We don't do that anymore. We want the ball in our hands, and we want to head the other way.
It's probably also instinct a lot of times. If you see a lot of green grass ahead of you, go ahead and grab it.
It's the exact right play to do. That's knowing when to break the rules and when to make a play that maybe you hadn't been taught.
Out of the end zone, here comes Hines. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, when we're having a tough patch, this too shall pass, and finally kept having a rough patch. He said, but you've got to do something to make it pass, and that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. Cousins on first down. He's going to let this go end zone for Hilton. And this is dropped.
Yeah, Bijan is gross.
Big gainer in his sights, but he could not reel it in. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Again, it's Cousins. Open man, this is Lewis. A gain there of 30 big ones. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete. From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. Play fake, Cousins. That's out to Hill, right side complete. 18 yards there, and it'll be a first and goal. They'll try to run with McCaffrey. 48 yards on the ground for him so far. McCaffrey diving for the end zone, and he is in. Touchdown.
Is that a comeback in the air? Against the Colts?
Now that shaves a bit off the lead. It's now a 23-point game. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And he'll be out of bounds here. The Charger drive about to get going. On first down, here's Stroud. The first catch of the game for George Kittle. A really nice game.
First, see the Twins.
Let's just call it what it is.
McCutcheon just homered. We're down 7-3. After Sonny Gray was perfect through six. Sorry, five. Perfect through five. Sonny Gray fucking blew it up in the six. He allowed four runs.
As they keep this drive rolling, it's another first down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Inside handoff, Henry. He'll be stopped at the 35, but not before he picks up 7 yards. A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. They'll run it again with Henry. And he'll get down.
Ninth.
Taken down just shy of the red zone at the 21. A solid run on first down. Gain of seven leaves him with a second and three. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get three before half. He hit his first, this one from 38. The kick by Carlson is good, and that will do it for this first half. So we've come to halftime after a very one-sided beginning.
Final adjustments being made for the second half. Whether they'll mount them up to the game, it's already pretty well decided. Well, that's another question. Nevertheless, let's get you back out to Brandon and Charlie.
It's going to be done.
Coach, thank you very much as we welcome you back for quarter number three. And how about this right out of the locker room, an onside kick attempt. So the Chargers will start the second half with the lead and the football as we're underway in the third quarter. And this will not work out. The Chargers able to recover. A very interesting. interesting call and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
The sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know the special teams coordinators, they sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? And I guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get it, coach, we can get it. And that came together with that sense of urgency you talked about.
From the 46, here's a second and seven. A shotgun snap to Stroud. There goes a deep ball, end zone. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. On third down, Henry. And great blocking downfield as he's got this almost to the 35-yard line. 80 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon. We've seen him break off a big run already in this game, and for a second, that one looked like it might be another.
Yeah, I think that any defense would say, we can't let him get to the second level, because sometimes he'll break off the big run on his own, but oftentimes you get additional blocking at the second level, which gets you deeper into the secondary.
Pushes past him. A solid stiff arm. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again. Again, it's Henry. And good downhill running. He's got 6 yards down to the 13.
Yeah, another good run there. He's been such a big part of their success here this afternoon. And that last carry, it puts him over 100 yards now for the day.
Inside 4 minutes to go, third quarter. On second down, here's Henry. Bulldozing, and he's in for a Charger touchdown. Derrick Henry, his third touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And the Chargers have got it on cruise control. Carlson on for the PAT.
That's whatever, dude. I don't really give a fuck. It's not fun anymore. No. It's comeback to the season, bro. No.
On the return, it's Nyheim Hines. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this about the 23.
I bet I could.
It's now to start their next drive. Well, we're still in the third quarter, so there's some time to kind of clean this up and make it look more respectable now. A win, that's probably gone out the window, Charles, but I don't know. Do you look at this as a time to just improve and maybe start to look towards the future?
I think you have to find something to play for, something to grasp on.
Oh, dude, I jumped like a motherfucker.
On paper going in.
Oh, yeah.
This one has turned out to be everyone's worst nightmare realized.
Oh, ball, Kirk.
There, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Well, we saw that he had a lot of success last week throwing the football, but that hasn't translated to this week. But with his team behind, I don't expect him to back off. I expect him to keep firing.
Cousins to throw for it on fours. And oh my goodness, here's a fifth interception. Picked off by a kettle.
Well, yeah, dude, I'm throwing every single pass. Just fucking chucking. Yeah, dude. Definitely not Derrick Henry. No chance. No chance. That's not a lot for player of the week.
It's week four of the NFL, and it's presented by EA Sports. It's the Vikings and the Panthers, and it comes your way next.
Uh-huh.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over.
Yeah, he's great.
Right out of the gate, we're gonna get a delay.
Delay of game.
So they accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit.
Still first down.
Hope not.
And a first pass for Cousins. He'll get this out right here to McCaffrey. And he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of four. Now Cousins. Open man is Hill. He's got it. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And now that sets up third and two. They go play action. Cousins. He's going to rifle one deep left side. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
Well, that might have been a situation where even though you don't hit on the deep throw, you at least put in the defender's minds early in the game that we're going to press the ball deep against your secondary. And that can have a ripple effect on how they function throughout.
Got a man. It's Tonyan. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. The conversion is successful.
No, I got adjustments. Please.
The former Panther has some great years with him. It's Christian McCaffrey. He'll get it up near midfield at 49 before being taken down. 4 yards. The numbers for McCaffrey last week. 9 carries, 52 yards, and a touchdown.
And that's just not enough carries for a running back to get loose and really feel like he's into the game, because they have to have enough volume to establish a rhythm, not just for themselves, but also to get in sync with their offensive line so they can read the blocks properly and they can execute. I expect them to get a minimum of 15 carries in this game, and the optimum number would be 20+.
Off the play fake, Cousins. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Jalen Phillips, the former first rounder, in their first sack. Rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Cousins. That one complete to Hill. He's in the space past the 25.
Who's streaming this slaughtering? Bursch. Yeah, Bursch, fucking back out of your search, fucking idiot. Yeah, look at how stupid you sound. Anyone trying to go to the Twins game tomorrow? That right. Bursch's favorite. Oh, you just click stream.
The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. They've got a 3-0 lead and the football as they start first and 10. Start a drive. That flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit.
Still first down.
Give running left, it's McCaffrey.
I don't know my Twitch account.
His own 19-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. Well, this defense for the Panthers, they were terrific a week ago in the win over Seattle.
And how'd you like to be the quarterback reviewing the game tape from last week and seeing this defense on the spot on almost every snap? If the ball was in the air, they took it away. If the ball was caught free, they picked it up.
The Vikings with the football here to begin the second quarter. As they've got it facing a second and long situation. Throwing is Cousins. And going deep for Hill. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete.
I like the fact that he took the shot deep downfield. Even if you don't get the catch, maybe you get a defensive penalty and pick up the yardage that way.
First down, here's Cousins. And going deep for Hill. And that is incomplete.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit, and they may have to change accordingly.
And they'll get it up a little shy of the 15. They'll spot him down at the 14-yard line. Trying to find some space to operate, and now they're on a gain of 12. A big first down to get away from the end zone. To throw, Cousins. Flush to his right. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. McCaffrey on the counter. And he'll lose yardage on this one back to the 13. 2 yards the loss, and now 3rd and 12. We'll see what they have drawn up here. A little bit of a line. 2 yards needed to gain a first down. They complete it to Hill. And they're going to get him down well short of first as he can only get this to about the 19. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. On first and 10, Cousins. And going deep for Hill. And he backs it away, and it falls down incomplete.
They decided the opportunity was there and launched a deep ball. But he was unable to get away from the defender. Couldn't create space. Couldn't uncover at the end of the route, and that one winds up incomplete.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
Cousins again. He's got it to Hilton. And boy, he is close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. So instead of giving them another third down, they'll decline it, brings up four.
Now that's smart football right there. You don't even have to really...
Oh, Jordan's upset. Damn.
Ha 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 ha. You mad or nah?
With a run by McCaffrey. Now he finds a little bit of room, enough for 4 yards. It'll be second down. Give him 4 yards on the play, and that will lead us into the 2-minute warning. Second and six, just inside the 30. Now Cousins. And going deep for Hill. This is caught inside the 15. A big play there for Minnesota. Even 60 yards. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. Now a draw play to McCaffrey. And that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped to the backfield. What a difference a play makes. A huge step forward and now a small step back as he loses a yard or two. Throwing. Cousins. The crossing route and hits Watson. Touchdown Vikings. Christian Watson, his first touchdown on the year. And the Vikings will take the lead here in the final minute of the first half.
And that touchdown gives them a touchdown.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they got it first and 10. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And a productive gain out to the 14 after starting at the 7. It's a gain of 7.
Hit had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. And he'll lose yardage on this one back to the 13. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a 3rd and 4 coming up.
And that's what this defense is going to need to do more in the second half. Good pressure that time, forces some indecision in the backfield. He's going to wind up being taken down for a nice loss.
Now throwing on 3rd down there, but he cannot connect.
Good work there to force the incompletion and 4th down. Normally, it'd be a quick change for the punt return unit, but this offense has converted twice on 4th down so far, so... You may want to double-check things there and make sure they're actually going to kick the football.
Now Cousins on 4th down. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert. And they turn it over. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Cousins now to throw on 1st down. And going deep for Hill.
He is both those things.
Here's Cousins. And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's 3rd down.
Tough series for the passing game. Things just and get this series back on track with a completion for enough yardage for a 1st down.
On 3rd down, Cousins. And the throw there going to be incomplete. We drop you. set to take over. A quick throw complete to Chark. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. 17 yards is the pickup there for number 17.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive and afloat, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
You're hideous.
Territory just across midfield at the 49.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
So you're saying if I go to your stats, Geno Smith didn't have three picks.
6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Oh. Geno fucking Smith.
Wanted to get done. They know how valuable he is to this team.
Absolutely a key component to what they do and what they do well. And if they want to continue to have success in the future, they knew they needed him and they got the deal done.
And then the move is way forward for about four. Second and six. Ball on the 40 now. Here's second and six. Play action now. Cousins. Toward the sideline. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. Frank Reich, not so sure about that last call. He's going to go ahead and throw out the challenge flag. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah, it certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, that's pretty tight.
Now here's the call. So the challenge there does not go their way. This will indeed remain a completed pass. That one complete. He finds Sharp. Call it a gain of six on the play, and it's second down. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Cousins. Oh, he'll want that one back. Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department. Third down. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. Cousins from the gun on third. Firing quick. Oh, no, he wants the football. And this is going to kick out of bounds. Fortunate bouncer two there. They'll keep possession back inside the 10-yard line. A field goal could get them the lead, but it might not be enough here as they come up on first and goal. From the shotgun to McCaffrey. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop him right around the one. 5 yards, a good run there, and now second and goal.
All right.
Strike quickly to take the lead here in the fourth.
for the extra point, and that makes it a 17-10 score. After the touchdown, out is Pinder to kick. Nyheim Hines now out of his end zone. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. And now out comes Minnesota. And now they'll look to answer working from behind. And remember, this offense has sputtered yet to score here in the second half. They'll need to change that here. Meanwhile, Cousins throw brought in by Watson. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield.
Oh, also, Julio Rodriguez had another four-hit game.
Here in the fourth, they just need to keep working their way downfield, and when they see openings, take their shots.
Probably is.
A misconnection there. He's hit on just 50% of his passes thus far. That's not where you want to be.
Now you see the evolution of the game. You go back to the quarterbacks of old, 50% would be terrific because they threw the ball downfield almost every time they throw it. Now with the short passing game, you should be above 60% just to be in the average range.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
I know at times people think we use it too often, but you've got to be able to throw guys open. And when you read zone, you've got to stick it in there before your receiver gets to the next guy in the zone. Otherwise, you bring him into the play.
And that's
that's just nasty. Perfect, bitch, leave me a phone. Over Dwayne, bitch, give me a phone.
50 yards. Perfect. Game here in fourth. We are set up for a fantastic finish now. A fourth quarter touchdown here. We're an extra point away from a tie football game.
And I know they're thinking about possibly going for two, but I'd go ahead and kick this one and just get it back to level.
Don't forget the extra.
Okay, my team's given up a 99-yard touchdown and a 47-yard touchdown.
Hines. And he returns this to the 22. Tyreek Hill making his way back out towards the huddle. And I know that they've double-teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. And how many times have we done games where we've seen a guy have a big game like this? But it's usually not by himself, is it? But usually it opens it up for other people to have big games as well.
Here's first and 10. A first down throw for Cousins. And he'll dump this up to his running back, McCaffrey. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Here comes second down.
TJ Hockenson has a pack of Zins on the sideline. Yep, it's in his hand right now and they're showing him. He's just it's the blue ones, light baby blue.
Now Cousins.
Yeah, dude, you know he's ripping those all game long. Yeah, I need about 2 tins.
Nice.
That's so lit. I wonder if he's got one in while he's on the line. Got to. I mean, he wouldn't be able to stop, right? Yeah, every single fucking snap I was on the field, I had his in.
That's caught. It's McCaffrey again. And the
That's so hot.
Wasn't enough, and we are off to overtime. Don't change that dime. It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession. And after both teams get a possession, then we're into sudden death. First team to score wins the game.
So the Panthers going to get the football first here in overtime as the kick is away. And no return here to begin the overtime session. That'll be a touchback. Carolina getting set to take the field. All set up for...
Yeah, Derrick Henry's not falling.
They start on the ground with McCaffrey, and he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
You've got to be impressed by that defensive front on reps like those. Not being moved off the line, kept their shoulders square, and gave their teammates time to fight to the ball and limit that game.
Now a throw here to his running back, and he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here.
Me and Vinfrin got damn good thing going anyway when we're in a random fling. Get my dick on my clip. Get this.
Materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it. On play action, Cousins. Now a diving effort right sideline. He's got it. He's padding his already great numbers here in overtime. More importantly, though, moving his guys downfield.
And I think that's exactly what's going through his head right now. Moving them downfield, putting them in a position to win the game. The stats, that's for the fantasy guys. I know they're enjoying that show.
And he's over 100 yards now after that last catch. Already, of course, leading the NFL in receiving yardage.
So he's done nothing at all to hurt his cause, to stay in that spot. But I've been so impressed with how he's gotten it done. Body control, route running. How about the way he competes for the football at the end of the play?
The coverage keyed in on him since that last completion his way. He earned a lot more attention on that route. And that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw his way.
The Panthers are going to take another timeout. They'll be left with just one remaining here at OT. And on third and five, this will be the eighth play of the drive. Throwing his Cousins. Set up the screen. That's complete. And he'll be taken back. He does have first down yardage. Now a timeout called for by the offense. So we'll take a break with him and be right back. Now a timeout called for by the defense. That's their second and last timeout here in the overtime session. We'll be back. First and 10, Cousins. Another grab here for the dynamic Christian McCaffrey. Now the timeout comes here in the waning seconds of this overtime as we could be set up at long last for a potential game winner. And he got it. The kick is good in overtime. He's able to split the uprights. And it'll be a fun time for the Twin Cities tonight. The Vikings win it. And for the visitors, it is going to be a happy flight home. It is always such a treat, Charles, in the NFL when you can go on the road and get a victory, and that's exactly what they accomplished here today.
Oh, the trip home is so much sweeter, isn't it? All the noise they heard before, how tough it is to win on the road, how tough it is to play in this stadium, how hyped up that crowd's going to be. They just used it as fuel, came in full confidence, believed in themselves, and got it done.
So for the Vikings, they're on a nice early roll as they move to 3-1 with a win here.
Talking a lot of shit over there, Jordan. What's the score in that game? Bursh! Bursh! Bursh!
Thank you.
challenge. For this next challenge, you need to complete all the challenge goals to get the win. You can view the goals at any time from the pause menu.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. The interception in great field position. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. And we see our first touchdown of the game. Here's first and goal. Pickett will look to throw it here. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
But there's an incompletion, partner, and the struggles through the air continue because so far their lack of passing production has led to a lack of points.
Touchdown, Bears! Jonathan Taylor, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Bears have moved out in front. So it takes just 3 plays here to find the end zone. And you remember, of course, this was all set up by their defense.
Yeah, they got the stop on 4th down. So I imagine the offense said to their defense, thank you very much for this great starting field position. And like you said, 3...
I won. Game winning field goal in overtime. Yeah, I'm ready for it. We're gonna get there. I'll get there. I won't even make the playoffs. Well, hey, 1-0 has to go. All right, the game of the week. 2-0-4 kids. He had 140, maybe 130 last game for me. Kirk had 400. You didn't even score a touchdown. At least I scored a touchdown.
The Vikings are 3-1 here through their first 4 games. They were winners their last time out, so they'll be looking to make it 2 in a row.
And so much about football, partner, comes down to mindset. Being in the right frame of mind, and the best way to get in that good frame of mind, winning. So they come in feeling good. They get home crowd behind them. I think they're going to be tough to beat in this one.
He was trying to get it to Tyreek Hill that time. And it's second down. You talk about this Chiefs defense. Right now they're ranked number 29 in the NFL against the pass. So fourth
and it's really difficult to prepare for this team. This is the number one overall passing team.
I'm ready.
But it shouldn't be hard to get excited about playing against them.
Am I it?
Ultimate test going against that unit.
And that's why you and I are excited to broadcast this game.
Yes, sir.
And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. This is caught inside the 15.
They're able to
got McCaffrey. They'll get two out of that run, and it's going to bring up a second and goal. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
Got his man complete over the middle. It's Hill. And from the 5-yard line. Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, and now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing.
And they're going to get to him, a sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. And it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Deshaun Elliott. And the Chiefs are going to get possession here. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And the pressure too much that time as Cousins goes down. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Now Cousins. Oh, and his early strikes continue. Here's another one intercepted. Picked up by Nick Bolton. And he will bring this down.
Did you play your game already?
The offense set to take the field.
Yeah, I'm in the middle of my game getting cooked. It's also really laggy. I don't know why the fuck it's lagging. I'm playing a fucking solo. Yeah, like every, like I'm lagging in a fucking solo franchise game. It's crazy.
So now this offense will take over and they will have the football at their own 20-yard line. First down, here's Cousins. And the Chiefs are gonna get him.
I just got sacked and literally all five of my linemen were running back towards the quarterback. And all four of their D linemen were on me. Like, what the fuck am I playing?
Look at this, middle of the field, a breakaway. Room past the 35 and all the way up to the 46. Cousins now to throw on first down. It's Hill, complete. Cousins trying to get his guys up to the line of scrimmage quickly. Second and five. Going deep for Hill. He's got his man. It's taken in for a Viking touchdown. So the offense set to take the field here. They will have the football with less than a minute to go in the first half. Cousins on first down. And going deep for Hill. And got his man complete to the 20. Touchdown, Vikings.
Okay, now I'm cooking. Should say Tyreek Hill's cooking.
It's a tie game as we drop you back in and the offense gets set to take over. And going deep for Hill. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Well, I guess we just discovered that someone is certainly not going to sit back and just take it in this game, huh?
No, they were trying to get that touchdown back in one shot.
One shot, trying to help out his defense and let the other team know they were coming after him.
It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown. Kirk Cousins with three touchdowns. Both offenses have been kicking in this one. A lot of points on the board. We'll see if that trend continues. He's going to launch this deep for Watson. It's caught at the 25. So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. Shotgun handoff down to McCaffrey. He's got four down inside the 20 to the 18.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? They created some nice space for him.
Out to Hill, complete. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the five. He's been big. two touchdowns earlier. Now he's got a first down here. Throwing, Cousins. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. To throw is Cousins. Quick slant, Tyreek Hill with it. Only able to pick up two, and that leads us to third and goal. And they're going to speed things up here. Third and goal for Cousins. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. And the Chiefs are going to have it here as they'll start at their own. Now following the interception, this offense will get another shot at it as they'll quickly head back onto the field. They'll start on the ground. First down. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Logan Wilson that time there to bring him down. The stop for no gain brings up second and 10 from the 20. They go play action. Cousins. And going deep for Hill. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
Trying to get a big strike right there and hopefully tie this game up in the late going. But the coverage was there, and this winds up incomplete.
Another incompletion would certainly be ideal defensively. A big play now. This is third and 10. Over the middle, that's complete to McCaffrey. And he will have a Vikings first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
It's so frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back.
Almost.
And late, tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or take away.
Basically just running out of time. I'm up by 7, 3 minutes to go. Need to get in field goal range.
At the 44-yard line. This is McCaffrey on the give. And to the
I'm up.
Taken down there 7. After getting 8 yards. Well,
All the good relievers get me fired up.
Fun to watch these offenses.
That's fire. Think about just like a 86 JJ or Tyreek out of one of those. Oh, did that get your ass?